In this video, we will provide instructions for the proper installation of AMI's Model 3010BX Trace H2S Analyzer. It will include details for basic mounting, electrical connections, gas connections, and sensor installation. AMI's BX series analyzers have markings for use in Class 1, Division 1, Group B, C, and D hazardous areas, based on compliance with multiple North American and international certification standards. The 3010BX analyzer is designed for indoor or outdoor use within specific temperature ranges. The non-heated configuration is designed for ambient temperatures between 25 and 115 degrees Fahrenheit. The heated analyzer includes an internal 24-watt explosion-proof heater within the same compact footprint as the standard analyzer. This option allows the analyzer to function down to negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit. For even colder climates, the heated analyzer can be outfitted with an extreme weather enclosure designed for installations where the temperature can fall to negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. When installing the analyzer, try to place it at eye level using the 4 5/16-inch mounting holes in the back plate. It can be secured to a wall or mounted on a 2-inch diameter pipe using 2 2-inch by 5/16-inch U-bolts. If mounting the analyzer indoors, never mount it directly above a heat source such as a catalytic heater. The rising heat will exceed the analyzer's temperature range and degrade the analyzer's performance. For outdoor installations in hot environments, keep the analyzer out of direct sunlight by installing a shade structure or mounting a solar panel so that it will shade the analyzer. To begin the electrical connections, remove the explosion-proof cover and the white terminal safety cover. Verify that your analyzer's power configuration matches your needs. DC-configured analyzers will have a white piece of sheet metal with wiring information, while the AC version will have black sheet metal. In order to comply with the hazardous environment approvals for this analyzer and national electrical codes, explosion-proof electrical seal-offs must be used for Class 1, Division 1, and 2 installations. The bottom of the explosion-proof housing has 2 half-inch NPT conduit holes. Remove both red plastic protection caps and install conduit unions between the explosion-proof housing of the analyzer and the explosion-proof seal-offs. The electrical unions will allow you to avoid cutting wires if the analyzer must be removed for servicing in the future. The conduit port on the left should be used for power and alarm relay wires. The conduit port on the right is for analog output and RS-485 wiring. AC power, along with the opening and closing of alarm relays, produce both electrical noise and large inductive spikes that can have an undesirable effect on the measurement readings. Sensitive analog output signal wiring must be separated from the power and relay wiring using the 2 separate conduit ports. The green wire terminal block connectors are combination connectors that can be unplugged for easier wiring. The connectors can accommodate 12 to 24 gauge wire. Power must be in the range of 10 to 24 volts DC, or 100 to 240 volts AC, and correlated with the voltage configuration of the analyzer. Connect the power and alarm relay wires from the left conduit to the appropriate terminals. If you are using twisted, shielded cable for the DC power supply, connect the shield to the ground point shown on the terminal block. Next, connect the analog output with shielded wire and RS-485 wires from the right conduit to the appropriate terminals. When connecting the analog outputs to an EFM or equivalent device, you must use twisted, shielded cable. The shield or drain wire must only be connected at the analyzer's earth ground location shown. The other end of the shield should not be connected, or it will cause ground loops and a noisy output signal. Your analyzer has 2 isolated analog outputs that can be configured for either 1 to 5 volts DC or 4 to 20 milliamps. The outputs have been set up at the factory per your request, but they can easily be changed in the field by following the instructions in the operator's manual. It is important that the analyzer is connected to a high-quality, protective earth ground for both proper safety protection as well as RFI protection. A minimum 16-gauge wire should be run between the analyzer's external protective earth ground lug and an 8-foot ground rod or an equivalent quality grounding point. After verifying all electrical connections are correct, power up the analyzer and fill the electrical seal-offs with approved potting compound. The next step will be to initiate the pressure sensor before any gas connections are made. Press and hold down the arrow button until the PSI indication on the LCD begins to blink. Use the up or down arrows to adjust the display to read 0.0 PSI. Precautions must be taken to ensure that liquids in the pipeline do not make their way into the analyzer. To protect against warm, wet pipeline liquids reaching the analyzer, we recommend the installation of an AMI demister. The vertically mounted demister quickly cools the warm, wet sample gas to ambient temperature. causing liquids to condense out of the sample gas stream and drain back into the pipeline without any maintenance. AMI also recommends the installation of an LRP, which mounts on top of the demister. The LRP's unique membrane and diaphragm allow gas to flow through it while rejecting slugs of liquids such as water, glycol, or compressor oils that can be present in pipeline gas during pigging or other upsets in the operation. You are now ready to connect the pipeline gas to the sample port of the analyzer. The gas pressure to the analyzer must be in the range of 0.5 psig to 150 psig. If pressure exceeds 150 psig, you must install a pressure-reducing regulator. Slip a deburred length of 1/4-inch stainless steel tubing into the sample inlet compression fitting. Loosen the nut and pull it and the ferrules along the tubing to confirm both ferrules are present and properly oriented. Reconnect the nut and ensure that the tubing bottoms out in the fitting before tightening the nut 1 1/4 turn. Connect the other end of the sample tubing to either the pipeline gas tab, pressure reducing regulator, or AMI LRP with demister. Slip another piece of deburred 1/4-inch stainless steel tubing into the exhaust port of the analyzer and connect it in the same manner. It is important that the exhaust tubing runs in a downward direction to an area where pipeline gas can be safely vented. The downward drain will prevent any condensate from draining back into the analyzer. The exhaust line should not be combined with the exhaust lines of any other equipment. You must now leak check all sample gas connections. Rotate the analyzer's three-way valve to the off position and pressurize the sample line. Using a squeeze bottle of Snoop or equivalent product, leak check every fitting from the analyzer's inlet port back to the pipeline sample tap. The H2S sensor has been already installed at the factory and is located behind the cell cap. After a successful leak check, turn the three-way valve to the sample position and adjust the flow through the analyzer to 1 SCFH using the metering valve. Within a few minutes, the sample line will be flushed and the LCD will accurately display the H2S value within the gas stream. For sensor replacement, turn the three-way selector valve to the off position and remove the cell cap. Carefully open the sealed sensor bag with a pair of scissors. Remove the sensor using the black handle and install into the open sensor pocket, making sure to align the sensor contact PCB with the cell block's opening. The black handle should be facing out of the sensor pocket. Reinstall the cell cap and hand tighten. Rotate the three-way selector valve to the sample position and adjust the flow to approximately 1.0 SCFH on the analyzer's flow meter. The total elapsed time from opening the sensor package, installing the sensor, tightening the cell cap, and flowing sample gas should take less than 1 minute. You can now calibrate the sensor by following the instructions in the operator's manual or watching AMI's calibration video. Proper installation and calibration of AMI analyzers will ensure the accuracy and long-term high performance AMI analyzers are known for. Let AMI help you with all of your oxygen, hydrogen sulfide, and moisture analyzer needs.